Am I the only one who find this cover extremely inappropriate? Now, let me give you some background history. Now, this guy, Mr. YG, he had a song called Meet the Flockers, where, of course, he referenced breaking into a Chinese house because they usually don't like banks for some reason over there in LA. So, of course, he got some flack about it. Some people say that he was supposing a hate crime. And there was actually people who broke into houses in LA that said that they listened to YG's Meet the Flockers to learn how to break into houses. So, of course, it was a big thing. And YG, of course, I think he didn't apologize for it or nothing. So, yeah. So to see him today, this motherfucker has a dragon in the background, which of course dragons are big in the Far East Asian culture. I'm like a little bit baffled, but there's even more referencing to this extreme controversial thing that happened in his career. But let me give you some background history. So YG is a gangster. I think his YG means young gangster. He is, of course, signed with a Young Jeezy affiliate. And he blew up with the song, Who Do You Love? And his album, Brazy, which was described as a gangster version of Mad City. You know, it was pretty great. And he's coming out with this right now, and let's just get into it. So YG, I don't know if he did this intentionally or unintentionally, but he pretty much ripped off Cardi B. YG ripped off Cardi B with this intro track. Cardi B had this song called Get Up 10, and YG pretty much parodied it with 10 times, since it's 10 times harder to be a gangster and a thug throughout his life. So yeah, and YG with such mastering of the English language as if I change up, they're gonna say I changed up, and also fuck the president, which is referencing his track Fuck Donald Trump, which I wish was on here because it was a huge ass banger. I don't care if it's old or not, still pretty nice song. And then we reach a song like Bulletproof, where he says he fucked the girl and then he traumatized her. How, YG? Was it rape? I mean, shit. Was she a virgin and shit like that? Was the dick like that strong? A little bit baffling. And of course, the next track, YG pretty much bites off 6ix9ine with the whole and the ad-libs and kind of Playboi Carti. It sounds very much influenced heavily by both of these two, and I mean in a bad way. And again, A$AP Rocky admits to wearing fake jewelry when he was 13. A little strange. A$AP Rocky and Little Yachty are the only two people I know of to actually admit rocking fake jewelry when they were kids. Soo Woo had this little funny response where he asked, since he's a blood, how do they feel about making the new Benjamins blue, and he said, I ain't mad, which was pretty funny to me. Like, that was a pretty clever and funny shit. Like, if he brought that energy and actually sense of humor throughout all his tracks, this would have been an easy 10, but no, he didn't. And also, after ripping off, you know, 6ix9ine style, he rips on 6ix9ine with that whole pink-haired blood shit, which is referencing 6ix9ine, how he had rainbow hair, and how he was the supposed blood and shit like that, blood this, blood that, blood walk, all types of shit. And he also did a response called, I think, the blood walk a bit before this. And speaking of ripping off, he had the song called Too Cocky, which, of course, A$AP Rocky already had a song called Too Cocky. And even a person like Cardi B referenced A$AP Rocky's Too Cocky, which, you know, Cardi B featured with YG, but still a little odd that they would still have the same title, or at least a damn near similar title. And he referenced being too cocky for his shirt, which I don't know why. Maybe he's referencing to him wearing a vest on the fucking album. I don't know. And why is he wearing a vest when he's bulletproof? It's all baffling to me. The too cocky for my shirt line was maybe like reminded me too much of too sexy for my shirt, tell you the truth. And again, here's YG culturally appropriating Asian culture when he referenced hibachi. Nice. Now, going from controversy to controversy, of course, YG had Big Bang and Big Sean. He mentioned Colin Kaepernick, which, of course, was censored in the NBA game. But, of course, they had it flipped and shit like that, which was pretty cool. And it also have 2 Chainz on it, which is pretty ironic because on the song Too Brazy, it does have a reference to having 2 Chainz and getting taxed on it, which means robbed. So it's a little bit odd why they would like sneak this 2 Chainz like that. Another thing that's a little baffling is the song Slay featuring Quavo. Now, since Quavo and the Amigos been saying some homophobic shit, I'm wondering why the hell would they use a term like slay, which was popularized by the gay community? A little odd. And of course, taking a page from Kendrick on power, YG referenced the power of that coochie, which, you know, except he did it less clever, you know. Kind of reminds me of the song, What Did the Black Man Say?, when Kendrick referenced how that coochie has power. But that's not only the only reference to coochie, as the song Pussy, Money, and Fame also referenced the What Would You Do for Pussy challenge, which was old as shit. Triple Six have the same old YG doing an impression of old head being mad at this generation for shit that they were doing in their generation back in the day. Impression, you know, that was done on Handgun and also Tripper Six on here. YG decides to bite off Rick Ross by mentioning Deeper Than Rap and also mentioned that he's been kind of a loner dad because of all this touring and haven't had time to spend with his daughter on the track too. Now, the interlude kind of reminds me of Ty Dolla $ign and how he had a whole album talking about freeing his brother and shit like that. You know, it was a pretty nice little moment on the album. Brompton's Finest, of course, have a reference to Nunchucks, which again, YG, why are you culturally appropriating Asian people and Asian culture? Overall, the album wasn't impressive, you know. But it was an easy listen, so I gave it like a 4, you know. This is YG really have to improve. I remember when he used to make tracks with a concept, a theme, and shit like that. And he was not the best lyricist, but at least he could stick to a fucking point. Anywho, please like, subscribe, share this video, and this shit gets a 4. Goodbye.